And a very good Tuesday to everybody, the fifth day of October 2021. My name is Jewel, and thank you so much for clicking play and checking out the weather with me today here at the J7409 Weather Channel. I appreciate it a lot. You know, folks, October 5th, I can't ever forget this day. This is the day that I was in my head-on collision. Anyway. Getting on with the weather. Severe weather today. It looks like we're going to be having some isolated severe thunderstorms with large hail and damaging winds. They're going to be possible across parts of Arizona this afternoon and early evening. Right in Arizona here. This is this afternoon and early evening. Maybe a little bit of the southern tip of New Mexico too. Now also we're going to be having some severe storms over parts of the Mississippi and Alabama area this afternoon, as you can see right in here. Other than that, all the way up to Washington State, some parts of northern Oregon, everyone else in the green. Of course, this means we do have a chance of some rain or a slight thunderstorm to pop up, with the most severe in these areas, Alabama, Mississippi, and especially in Arizona. Now, we do have a 2% chance of tornadoes that could pop up in Arizona for this afternoon and the early evening hours. So far as the severe wind, 5%, very same areas, Arizona, southern New Mexico, Alabama, a little bit of Mississippi here, and that large hail can be expected with some of these storms if you happen to get one of the right cells pass by in the very same area. So please watch your skies and be aware of what might be coming your way later today. As we look ahead, this is like the 10th through the 14th coming up in the near future. This is what the temperatures should be looking like across the lower 48. And my goodness, it's going to get cold up in Idaho, Nevada, parts of California, Oregon, some of Washington State. And it's going to feel a little cooler all the way over to North and South Dakota, moving right on down through New Mexico. Now, everybody else, we're going to be on the warmer side, especially from Maine down to the Panhandle, a little bit more Florida, large area of Texas. Very, very warm temperatures. Now, this is the 10th through the 14th of October. Now, we're going to come over to the air temperature. This is a courtesy of Tropical Tidbits. I've already got this set on the 10th, as you can see, Sunday the 10th. Remember the cold air moving through. You can see right in these areas here, 29 over here, and the low 40s. Maybe 60 in most of the places down here in Colorado. We got some 38 in the mountainous ranges. We're going to move on through, and you're going to see how these temperatures are going to start to fall. My goodness, 28, 37, 49, moving right along here. In California, Northern California, you're going to have 40 nighttime temps looking like, but we're going to move on through. And you're going to see just exactly how this cold front that's going to push down from Canada, it's going to start to affect a lot of people. A lot of people. You're going to start getting a cool up. So for all of the warm weather lovers that are in the western sections and northwestern sections of the U.S., forget it. Coming up in about 5 or 6 days from now, it is going to start to cool up. Now, everybody else, of course, is going to be staying warmer, like I showed you. We'll move on through to the 14th. Woo! Getting down to 15 up here in Idaho, 18 in Wyoming, 25 in Utah. And now it looks like Northern California, you are down to 35. In these areas right here. Look up in Canada, getting cooled off for sure. Minus 19 right there. We'll just move this on through to the 14th. And you can see how this cold air is going to start pushing east. And here we are right here. What about precipitation? If you guys have any precipitation, it just probably is going to be in the form of snow. So let's check that out. So far as what the precipitation is looking like as of now, the 10th through the 14th of October, everybody over here, hopefully we're going to get some dry weather. Okay, not specifically dry. We can still get some rain, but it should be more or less like normal. Everybody in the white. Up in Maine, parts of New York, Vermont, New Hampshire, dry, dry, dry to the bone. Same going over here for New Mexico and portions of Texas. But we do have a lot of precipitation going on over in these areas from Oregon all the way across to Minnesota. Of what form of precipitation should this be? Well, according to the temperatures, some of it should be snow. So let's go see. Now, over at Tropical Tidbits, we already have this set for October the 10th. As you can see right here, we're just going to click through some, and you can see that some of that precipitation is beginning by the 11th to turn to snow in Washington State, a little bit of Oregon, parts of Idaho, moving right on up through Montana. So we move on through. Let's get on up. Doesn't look like a whole lot, but looks like you're going to get a good dusting, if nothing else, over in these areas as you move through. There's a 12th, while everybody else is getting rain. Now, it does look like by 6 p.m., the 6Z run on the 5th, this snow could get heavier in portions of Utah, portions of Wyoming, and some of Montana. It's going to move on across, as you can see. Still, everybody else just getting rain over on the eastern coastal sections here and in the sections of Oklahoma moving up. But this snow band, it kind of progresses and gets a little bigger by late in the afternoon on the 12th, bringing snow from Colorado, Wyoming, the Nebraska Panhandle, moving right on up in North and South Dakota. And remember, this went through the 14th that I just showed you. Heavy snow in North and South Dakota, still in snow in the Panhandle of Nebraska. You can see all of the snow moving in right in this area. So we'll hop on up. Boy, that's really a tough snow band right there moving through. What will it look like by the 14th? Minnesota still getting rain on the 13th as we move on across. Snow starts to come in a little bit in southern Minnesota here. And by the 14th, just a little bit of snow in certain areas of Minnesota. And then moving, creeping right on up. So you guys should get probably just a dusting or something like that. I'm not calling for a big snowstorm, but I just want to let you know this is a powerful low, as you can see. So I'm pretty sure it's going to get windy. It's going to be a mess for you folks. So be aware of what's coming up in the next 5 to 6 days. Tropical weather. As of now, we can all take a little break. Isn't that a good thing? My goodness gracious. However, though, we still have this little disturbance, number one. It's still disorganized. I've checked everything out. Don't worry, folks. It's just disorganized showers and thunderstorms. It's east of a surface trough. Now, this trough extends from the central and southeastern Bahamas northward over the adjacent southwestern Atlantic waters. Now, upper level winds are not expected to be favorable for significant tropical development of this system, and it's going to move slow northwestward over the next several days. And by the weekend, looking like it's going to interact with a front near the coast of the eastern United States. Nothing in 2 days, 5 days, 10% chance. However, once it does move on out, the waters are still warm in here. It could form into something, but right now I don't think it's going to be a problem to any land masses. Down in the Bahamas, yes, you're going to get rain. You'll get some gusty winds, but nothing that you can't handle. That's what it's looking like right now. I just wanted to bring you up to date here on Sam. Sam's not on the map. None of them's on the map anymore right now, folks. But look, Sam's still a hurricane this morning. Sam's still got 80-mile-per-hour winds, and it's almost up here to going towards Iceland. Can you believe that? I wanted to show you this, and it looks like Friday. Even the further north it goes, it's still going to be a tropical storm. Sam was a storm, one of the most powerful storms of this year, folks. And I wanted you to see this. So, you know, don't always go by the water temperature. As a matter of fact, I've been doing some research, and a few years from now, they're probably not even going to categorize these when they get to a certain point. From information that I have found, they're just going to call them super hurricanes. The winds sustained will be 200 miles per hour, with 385 mile per hour gust and higher. Now, no one can stand that, can they? Well, I just wanted to throw that out there to you. As a matter of fact, in my research, I saw where a lot of places where people live, like Louisiana, Houston, Texas, these are just some of the examples I found. These people are going to be moving because the storms are just going to keep getting worse and worse and worse in the years to come. And I'm not talking a long time away. I'm talking about in the next 2 to 5 years. This is probably what we're going to be seeing. Have yourself a good day, a safe day, and a blessed day, my friends. Thank you so much for watching. If you haven't subscribed, I would ask you to consider to subscribe. Click the J7409 weather and symbol in the bottom right-hand corner. Click that bell and check off all to make sure you get all my latest weather videos. If you do this, I want to go ahead and thank you in advance. I appreciate it very much. Thanks to all my new subscribers, all my old subscribers, and all of you. I love you so, so very much. Much peace, love, and kindness to each and every one of you. Thanks for watching.